What if I told you there was a virtual revolution happening right now, and that every single one of you would be affected, if not today, then in the near future? It's staggering to think that VR has seen a resurgence in the past 4 years, and there are over 150 million virtual reality users in the world today.
Okay, he's behind you.
Now, these users range from everything from young kids to grown-ups to grandparents, like you just saw. That was an 81-year-old granddad who was using virtual reality for the first time. Now, part of what's been getting VR so much attention and hype over the past few years has been things like that, people's reactions to it. It's mesmerizing to watch. My whole life as a digital creative director, I've spent time trying to give people moments to escape reality. But my passion was sparked when I was a kid. My story actually begins in the early 80s. I was the youngest of four kids, and we grew up in quite a rough neighborhood. My mom taught me from a very early age that if I wanted to build a future for myself and get out of this place, I had to work really hard. Not just hard, but super hard. And that if I wanted something, I had to try to be the best at it. Now, we didn't have a lot. We had to share everything. And being the youngest of four meant I always had to wait till the very end to play with it. Everything from our first bike to our first scale electric set, and you can see how happy I was when I finally got my hands on it. And that horse that was on our playground was my favorite toy. Can you guess why? Because there were four seats, which means I didn't have to wait. So Mom taught me and drilled it into me every day. Work hard, she'd say. Build a better future for yourself. And my dad, well, he taught me that you can be anything that you want. And in fact, he taught me that being a girl should never stop me from doing the things that set my heart on fire. And I took that learning and those lessons from my parents to a completely different level. When one day, my dad brought home one of these. It was the Commodore 64. Now, I don't know how Dad managed to afford this thing, but he did. And it sparked my passion for technology that still exists today.
Good luck, son. Make us proud.
This year, 2 million families will send their kids off to college. But many of these kids won't be able to compete because they lack computer skills. A home computer can help. The Commodore 64 gives you more computer for less money than anyone else. Instead of saving for your kid's education, maybe you should spend a little for it.
And don't you love that at the end of that, they weren't targeting at young boys, they were targeting at young girls. It wasn't a Barbie doll that came out of that gift, it was a Commodore 64. Well, I spent most of my childhood trying to ace this. I wanted to be better than my brothers at everything. And I was pretty bad at it, and I can tell you. But I worked really hard. I practiced every single day when they weren't watching. And then one day, I played them, and I beat them, and I was pretty good. And I realized something, that if I worked hard and did something I enjoyed, I'd become pretty good at it. So good that it would make me feel invincible, because if I could beat them, then I could do anything, right? I loved being in the imaginary worlds when I was playing on that Commodore 64. It made me forget where we were from. It made me feel invincible. I could be a racing car driver. If I wanted to be, I could be a ninja. Or, even better, I could be a Ghostbuster. Right? Now, when I realized that I could beat my brothers at this, something happened. It gave me a level of confidence that I forgot where we came from. I forgot that we didn't have much. I forgot that we had to share everything. And I became so confident in what I could do that I knew hard work and passion would get me there. I turned that fear and I became fearless about everything. I spent a decade in my career as digital creative director trying to find experiences that would take people to another world, something that would be unforgettable, just as I did when I was a child and I played that Commodore 64. And as new mediums emerged, I harnessed the power of each of them, everything from the web to mobile to creating interactive immersive experiences. And then, in 2013, something really interesting happened. We pushed beyond the frame, and we received one of these. At the time, I was working at AKQA, a digital creative agency. We received the first DK1 headset, which was a developer kit from Oculus. When we tried it, something happened. I wanted everybody to try it. It gave me goosebumps. My legs turned to jelly. Something happened. I felt like that little child receiving the Commodore 64 again. These imaginary worlds transported us, and we were so excited. Within 8 weeks, we had pitched an idea to Nissan, one of our clients, to debut the Oculus Rift at the Tokyo Motor Show. It sounds crazy now I think about it. This was a technology we knew nothing about. We'd never ever used it. We didn't know how to play in it, but we were excited about putting this into the hands of young drivers so that they could concept their own cars. Working in a new technology and a new medium filled us with a sense of fear, joy, and this nervous excitement. It challenged everything we knew about immersive experiences. We had to change not only the way we worked, but the way we thought and approached these virtual worlds. But it was seeing the reactions of millions of people at the Tokyo Motor Show going through the VR for the first time, taking the headset off and being mesmerized. And I knew then that this wasn't a technology, this was an entirely new medium. And what was exciting, what excited me the most, is we had barely scratched the surface of what was possible. And so I decided to move my whole life to New York, where I joined Framestore's virtual reality studio. Now at the time, there were only a few studios in the world who were dabbling in the dark arts of VR, and I wanted to learn as much as I could. I wanted to be the best at it. Now over the past 4 years in VR, Framestore's virtual reality studio, we've created a number of experiences, everything that you can imagine, and all of them have been focused on transporting you to a completely different world, making you feel like you can do anything and be anywhere. But you know what? The most important thing I discovered in the past 4 years of working in VR is that working in any new medium is really about a mindset. Whether we transport you to being a Marvel Avenger in the heart of a battle scene, or whether we take a group of school kids on a bus, on an ordinary school bus, and then transport them onto the surface of Mars so that they one day may be inspired to go to Mars. Or whether we take you and put you into the heart of J.K. Rowling's Wizarding World, where you come face to face with the majestic Thunderbird. But VR is really about a mindset. It's not about a skill set. Working in any new medium requires you to be fearless, because it is hard work. We failed so many times, and every time we failed, I felt like I couldn't do this. But you have to be fearless in your approach. You have to believe that you can do it. You have to show grit and tenacity, and you have to know, of course it's going to be hard work, because if it was easy, then everybody would do it. VR is forcing us to work right outside of our comfort zones. It's challenging everything we know. And if you thrive in adversity, then this is the medium that you will want to play in. It's frightening, it's scary, and it's challenging all at the same time. And you have to take so many risks, but the rewards outweigh the risks. Now, what's exciting is we've barely left the starting blocks. This is the Lumiere brothers' arrival of the train. In 1895, they were pioneers in early filmmaking. They played this film, which was the first motion piece, to a theater full of theatergoers just like yourselves, who ran out of the theater screaming and shouting because they believed that train was literally going to hit them right in the face. I know, crazy, right? We are still in the early days of VR, much like the early days of filmmaking. It would take a decade of filmmakers to master their craft to even attempt the first feature film, which was the story of the Kelly Gang in 1906. And it would be many, many more many years later before they would craft filmmaking to achieve the greatness of what you understand to be a feature film today. Now, working in VR requires us to understand that it is still early days. Many people still think that VR is a fad and it's not going to take off. Well, let me put that into a little bit of context for you. When IBM CEO Thomas Watson said that there would only be a world market for 5 computers, he never imagined that in the next 50 years, there would be a computer in every single American household. Now, a huge caveat here. When Thomas was talking about computers, they were the size of a house. And sure, nobody really wanted one of those in their home. But that's the whole point. Any new medium starts off big and clunky. It gets more compact. It gets more affordable. And you have to have a vision about where it's going to go. You have to believe in its potential. And those that do will reap the rewards and benefits. Well, let's not forget Daryl Zanuck. He was CEO of 20th Century Fox. Now, he underestimated the power of the TV. He never imagined that the TV would not only one day, that plywood box that he thought was just a fad and people would get bored with it, not only would it be in every one of your households, but it would be slimmer than my iPhone. Now, we have to move beyond the spectacle of VR, and we have to start shifting our focus into a sense of purpose for this new medium. Right now, we are in the early days, but I imagine where VR could transform education. Imagine where VR could actually heal you, or imagine if VR could transform the way you train and perform as an athlete. Well, guess what? You guys don't need to imagine, because it's already happening. VR is transforming education in a way that I never imagined. The information that was once in a textbook is being lifted. You can step right into the heart of a human body and explore every single facet. It is changing the way we not only educate children, but ourselves. And the Army is using VR and exposure therapy to help war veterans recover from the traumatic experiences of war. We never imagined that a medium like this could be used in such a way. And the NFL in the USA have been using VR for the past few years, not only to measure athletic performance, but to actually improve athletic ability on the field. I imagine a world of possibilities for VR. Maybe it's the kid in me. I love to dream big. But imagine if virtual reality could change the way you learn, change the way you educate yourselves, change the way you heal, change the way you think about the world. I imagine a world where imagination and curiosity will power progress in this medium. And I believe all of this is possible. In the future, virtual reality is going to get more compact. It will be slimmer, it will be faster, and it will be more affordable, which means that over 90% of households will have a virtual reality headset or an augmented reality headset in their hands. And where we have only 6 degrees of freedom, I believe in the future there will be 100 degrees of freedom, which means you won't be limited to the space that in which I'm standing. In the future, I believe that virtual reality will be more connected, which means one day I won't be standing here in front of you, but we will all virtually be sharing the same experience together. I believe that it will change the way we connect as humans and change the way we interact. This week alone, Facebook announced Facebook Spaces. I wrote this presentation a while ago, and I already feel like the future's already happened. I can barely keep up. Facebook Spaces allows 4 of us to not only be in the same virtual world together, to hang out, to learn things. Imagine if you never had to go work again, you can virtually connect with anyone at any time. And I believe that virtual reality, coupled with artificial intelligence, will change the way we interact as humans. Imagine if you could put a headset on and you had your own digital human powered by AI to learn anything you wanted. Today, I'll learn a language. Tomorrow, I'll learn how to do heart surgery. The limitations, the things that virtual reality allows us to do is open up our world and create unlimited potential for humans. I believe all of this is possible. And as I navigate the virtual realms, I encourage you to do the same. It will be hard work. It requires grit. It requires you to push and yourselves right outside of your comfort zone. But when you do, it's so exhilarating. It requires you to deliver ideas with a sense of purpose, something that adds value to the world. Work hard. Work with people with the same mindset as yourself to be the best that you can be. And whatever you do in this medium, be fearless. Thank you.
Resh Sidhu, ladies and gentlemen.